Zone tonight, the 13th season on Channel 13 of Prep Football. Can't get any better. This could be the year. By Ryan Starr was playing here earlier. Is it going to be the Bulldogs' year? We'll know soon. Charles Tiger Edwards, Hunter Robinson to call this one. Hunter, the Bonnabel Bruins are here to take on the Fontainebleau Bulldogs. What do the Bruins have?
Well, the Bruins are going to have to establish the ground game early. They run a basic run offense, and it's going to be even more important to get off to an early start today because they're playing without their top receiver from last year, Jamal Evans, who had a freak neck injury earlier in the spring and is still recovering. So they need to get things going on the ground early on.
On the ground. They're going to ground and pound if they can. The Fontainebleau Bulldogs, though, little different situation offensively.
Well, they're going to be running the spread offense, and the important thing for them to do is to get out and score early and get ahead, because then that will force the Bruins to throw the ball, and that's not their forte.
That's not their forte. So, tonight, the Bonnabel Bruins come to Fontainebleau to take on the Bulldogs. Both teams 0-0. Who's going to get their first victory? Pre-game with Coach Mike Matern. Coach, the good thing about tonight is nobody has a loss as of right now. Coming out of this is going to be number one. How important is it to get this victory?
It's very important. It should set the tone for the rest of the season, I'm hoping. You know, they've been working hard. We'll see how it goes.
They're going to try to pound the football, run right at you. What you got for them?
Well, we got a few different defenses that blockers got up his sleeve, but yeah, we know they're big. Their offensive line's big, and they got some good running backs, good quarterbacks. You know, they rotate their quarterbacks, and both of them pretty good.
Defensively, they've got some experience. Give us a rundown on, I don't know, what year this is, two or three of the spread. How do you think you're working that?
This is the second year we're actually in the spread. And right now we've still got two quarterbacks, and we still haven't made a decision. They're both pretty equal. Hopefully after tonight we'll be able to make that decision. But both of them run the offense well. We have, I think, a really good group of receivers this year. I got five or six guys that should be rotating in. So we're well ahead of where we were last year with that.
Pre-game with Coach Reggie Rogers. Coach, 1-9 last year. It's important you get off to the right start tonight.
It's very important against a quality opponent. So we're just looking to play well and improve on last year.
We have got a little rundown on you. Like to run the football. How important is it that you're able to establish the run game tonight?
It's very important. It's the key to everything for this offense to go. We have to establish a run game and be very productive at it.
Defensively, you're pretty good. You got some veterans on that side of the ball. What are you going to need to do? They're in the spread. What are you going to need to do to shut them down?
Just pay attention to what's going on. You know, we taught our guys we had a good week of practice this week and kind of got a good look at them. And if things go well and we play well, we should be all right. We do what we do best and just play hard. You know?
Daniel Gonsolin to kick it off for the Bruins. 2000 in football season, 14 football season underway. Return is Hunter Bastion. Cuts it out the left side and going to be dumped around the 33-yard line. Number 88, Josh Kendrick of the Bruins on the tackle. Bulldogs will play a first and 10 there from the 33. Marquez comes in at running back. Kendrick Marquez. And from the pistol, Mason Blocker gets the starting nod. They check over to the sideline for the play from the offensive coaches as they've checked out the Bruins defense. Hand off up the middle. I checked that. That was a fake. They ran option. Little pitch out there. Totally got me.
I think they tricked everybody except themselves.
Right. Duplantis on the carry gets let's see, looks like about 7 yards, second down and three. So the first play of first offensive play, I'm totally faked out. I know what you're saying at home. That's usually the case. No backs this time with motion. Marquez back, blocker. Middle screen for Marquez. Run down from behind defensively by the Bruins.
That was a nice catch right there by Marquez to go up and bring that one in with one hand.
And we have our first down of 2014. The ball is sitting at midfield. Three left, one right for blocker. Out of the pistol, quick toss, complete to Bastion.
Blocker's pass complete to Bastion. Pick up a five.
Picked up about five on the play, second down and five for the Bulldogs. Man, a great way to start the year, huh? First down and getting 5 yards on first down is important.
And blocker looks really comfortable back there for somebody who doesn't have a lot of experience yet.
Two left, two right. Fake handoff, blocker's running up the middle. And gonna be brought down as he gets inside the 30, right around the 28. And that time, the little read option.
And that's one of the things that Coach Matern really likes about blocker, is that he can get out and use his legs, you know, to get a first down like he just did.
Nice run by the 6'3", 185-pound junior. First down, Bulldogs. Again from the pistol. Motion, handoff inside. That was Marquez on the handoff, and he got about three. So the Bulldogs kind of mixing it up, Hunter, early.
Yeah, they are, and it's, you know, it's nice to see them trying out the spread offense. Blocker's 2 of 2 already, so off to a quick start.
Second down, 7 for the Bulldogs. They go 3 right, 1 left. Blocker gonna throw. I think we had a whistle. Somebody left too soon.
Yeah, it looked like somebody jumped there on the line before the snap.
Dead ball penalty against the Bulldogs. Related procedure. 5 yard penalty. Second down.
Fake that time, and blocker keeps it, but he's gobbled up right there in the middle, so nothing on that play.
Yeah, the Bruins weren't going to let him break out and get another big gain on that one.
A little different kind of look this year for the Bulldogs to have that threat of a runner. Last year, not so much. More trying to get with the pass. Third down, 11. Pass complete right down the seam.
And a great job to hold on to that one with a big hit on the end of that play.
Noah Greer, a 5'11", 180-pound senior, gathered that one in, but he was wide open as he went right down the seam, and blocker put it on the numbers. First and goal now. As the Bulldogs go, hurry up. Blitz coming from the Bruins. Somebody moved. No whistle. Blocker dancing, making something out of nothing.
Mason Blocker takes it in.
And he scores. Wow. For a minute there, I thought they jumped off sides. And no, that didn't happen. He took it in.
Yeah, it looked like there was some movement up front before the play, but luckily for the Bulldogs, no whistle, no flag, and they get a touchdown out of it.
So the opening drive of 2014 for the Bulldogs turns into six. Olivier on to try to attempt the extra point. Knuckleball is good. 7-0. 8:38 to go. First quarter. Bulldogs up. Olivier to kick it off after the Bulldogs took the opening kickoff, marched right down the field and put up seven to lead this one. Bryant trying to get to it. It's in the end zone. That's going to be a touchback, automatic touchback, and they'll play, the Bruins will play their first offensive series starting at their own 20-yard line. I'm anxious to see, Hunter, this running attack that Coach Rogers has with the Bruins. They've got some, you can see they've got some bruisers in that front line.
Yeah, they do, and those big guys on the front line are blocking for three different running backs that Coach Rogers likes to rotate in and out. So it'll be interesting to see how he uses those early in the game.
Yeah, he's going to start with Samaj Franklin at quarterback. And they go no back, so there must be some kind of motion. There we go. We had a shift. Handoff inside Ambrose, and he got nothing. On the carry for
the Bruins, 23, Maurice Britton. Yeah, the offensive line just collapsed on that play. Bulldogs. Good play by the Bulldogs to get in there and stop him for no gain.
Brett Lewis, a 5'8", 250-pound senior, in on the stop, along with Chase Mundell, 6'3", 250, a senior. Second down 10 now for the Bruins. Low snap, Franklin was gonna throw it, changed his mind, runs. Indecisive right here, being run down. Almost got there by Maroney, gonna run it now. Gonna run out of bounds to a little safety. Travis Sears near him as he ran out of bounds. And he had to scramble for his life there.
Yeah, that could have been a very disastrous play. You know, the best thing for him to do there was probably to throw it away, but he did get a couple of yards out of it, but he could have been sacked for 7-8 yards of loss there.
And it all started with that low snap. So Franklin dodges a bullet, brings up third down and about eight. Signal coming in from the sideline. Play clock at 15, 14. Franklin looking at his play, whatever number was signaled in. He's got a little play sheet on his arm that he looked at. 3-2-1, too much time. Didn't get called. Long ball down the right side. Incomplete. Denzel Winsey went in motion across the formation and up the sideline. And the 25-second clock, I thought it run out.
Yeah, it did look like it expired. Officials didn't call it, and Winsey had the secondary beat down the sideline, but Franklin just couldn't hit him in stride, overthrew him a little bit.
So we have the first fourth down of this football game, and a punt going to happen. Or at least we expect a punt to happen. Cole Sisson and Hunter Basham back.
Terrell Henry punting for the Bruins. Check that, number 81. Luis Mejia is the punter.
So Mejia on the punt for the Bruins. High one. This one comes off the side of his foot. It's going to go out of bounds. And this is going to be maybe a 10-yard punt. But for Fontainebleau, great field position.
Yeah, this is going to be a big possession for them. If they can go up by 14, keep this offense rolling, that's really going to force the Bruins to start throwing the football, and that's not their forte.
So first down 10, quickly the Bulldogs out. They had a lot of success on that first series. They want to capitalize on that. A team like the Bruins, 1-9 last year, Hunter. And this is not how Coach Rogers wanted to start the year.
Yeah, it's definitely not. This is Coach Rogers' fourth year with the team. And the first two seasons, winning seasons, went to the playoffs, but really struggled last year. And it's not looking good so far in this first quarter.
They're going to need a big defensive play here. looking to the sideline is blocker. The play is on a whiteboard. You can't see it. It's not in your screen, but on the bottom right hand of corner of your screen, there'd be a whiteboard. Inside play, almost picked off. Wow, an inside throw goes incomplete and almost picked off.
Yeah, and a bit of luck there for blocker. If that was picked off, he was going to go a long way and we could be all tied up.
Well, it's what I said. The Bruins need a big defensive play. Almost got it there. Blocker, three-step drop, looking. Going to be brought down. Ball comes out. The ball does come out. And there's that big defensive play I was talking about. Number 57, Marcus Martin comes up with the loose ball. And the Bruins have improved their field position. But better yet, they have the football.
What a huge swing and momentum there. The Bulldogs get the ball back, up by seven, in great field position. They miss, almost throw an interception, get redemption, and then fumble it away anyway.
Wow. First down 10 now for the Bruins. Samaj Franklin at quarterback. Handoff inside, cutting back to the right side, up the field, cutting back. Great run by Maurice Britton. The 5'8", 170-pound sophomore goes left, cuts back right, up the sideline, and then cuts back. But we have a question on the field. Ooh, the dreaded yellow hanky. Holding. Wow. Very inopportune for the Bruins.
Yeah, the Bulldogs catch another break. That could have been first and goal at the 1 yard line. Instead, it's moving all the way back.
The ball will be about the 37 yard line. It'll be first and about 20. First and about 19, excuse me. At that point. Wow, what a great cut, double cut. Got it out to the sideline and then cut it back just to get down inside the five, down to the one.
Yeah, and then once he got to the outside, it was just pure speed, blowing by everybody. And they barely caught him, so let's see if the Bulldogs can capitalize on the flag.
Inside screen out here to Denzel Wenzie. From Franklin, and they pick up some of that yardage that they lost on the penalty. Gonna bring up second down and about 12, a long 12. Pick up of about seven on that one. Franklin. From the pistol, gonna drop, under rush, runs. Babin put the pressure on him. He's gonna be run down and thrown down there by Travis Sears. Sears came up and basically pulled him down by the jersey.
Yeah, Franklin has a lot of faith in his legs, and instead of throwing that one away, he thought he could cut the corner, but he just got a hold of his jersey and pulled him down for a loss again.
Well, he evaded Babin, who was coming on the blitz. We have a timeout with 5:56 to go in the first quarter. It's Fontainebleau 7, Bonnabel nothing. Coming out of the timeout, the Bruins are playing a third down and 13. Franklin dropping, gonna go deep up the left sideline, got a man! Knocked away defensively by number 6, Gavin Scholl. It appeared that the receiver was gonna blow by Scholl, but Scholl leapt up and knocked it down.
Yeah, he barely got his hand in there, and if he doesn't, that's a touchdown.
Well, Coach Rogers not afraid to dial up the long ball. I know that early.
Mejia is back to punt with Bastion back. Was that blocked? Or did it just come out of his hand? We have a flag on the field coming up here. Wow. So early first game jitters by both teams, a turnover by the Bulldogs, and here a special team miscue by the Bruins.
And that's right after the bad punt on the last possession too, so really struggling on special teams so far.
I didn't know if they got a hand on that or it just came off his foot. Looks like the penalties against the Bruins for holding, they're gonna decline that and take the ball over inside the 40-yard line at the 37, first down 10 for the Bulldogs.
And this will be an important possession to see how they bounce back from the fumble last time around. You know, they had good field position last time and coughed it up. So I know Coach Matern really hoping to pound one into the end zone again.
And it's been sink or swim right early for the Bulldogs. Locker, hands off inside, straight ahead. Not much going there. Right up into the middle of that Bruin defense, and you're not gonna get too far with the big boys there.
Yeah, Kendrick Marquez did a good job with a little second effort there to get maybe a yard or two in the play, but not much going.
Second down, 8 now. Blocker, 3-step drop, gonna tuck it and run. Saw something, cut back. Nice little move, still on his feet. Close to a first down. Yeah, I think he got a first down.
Making a stop for the Bruins, number 46.
Again, a lot of pressure coming that time.
It's another Bulldog.
And blocker just decides to tuck it and run.
He tucks it and runs, and then he shows the power, dragging the defender an extra 3 or 4 yards to get the first down and move the chains.
That was definitely a case of safe than sorry. First down, 10. Bulldogs rolling left. Blocker pulls up, got a man. Complete to Bastion. Hunter Bastion, 5'10", 160, a senior. Ran a little flat route out, and blocker on the half roll left hits him.
That was a dangerous throw there. When you look, when he caught that ball, he had 5 white jerseys around him, but he put it only where Bastion could catch it.
And we have a timeout. 4:21 to go, first quarter. Bulldogs up, 7-0 and driving. 9 yards on the pickup on that pass. Second down, 1. We're coming out of the timeout. Play is being signaled in. You can see that whiteboard. The play is on that whiteboard for blocker. He's going over the blocking right there with the offensive line. Drops back. We got motion. And we hand off inside. And that goes to Kendrick Marquez. Little inside run. And we have a penalty. First game jitters, Hunter. Lots of yellow flags, lots of miscues, as teams are still trying to work the kinks out.
And that can be expected early on in the season. And, you know, one thing we haven't mentioned yet is that the field is also a little sloppy out there tonight, which is why you might see some players slip in and sliding around.
Good point. Penalty results in a first down for the Bulldogs. Ball is on the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal for Fontainebleau. This time they put 3 receivers to the top of your screen and 1 to the bottom. Blocker looking back to the sideline. They're gonna go with the play. Inside move complete. And that went to Cole Sisson. Quick pass, boom. Touchdown.
Yeah, nice catch there by Sisung to just go up over the defender. A quick pass by blocker. The defensive back didn't even have a chance to see it come in.
And the Bulldogs have gone up 13-0. Extra point team coming on the field. Tyler Olivier, who knuckleballed it through last time, will have a chance to make it 14 here. Snaps there, kicks there. It's good. 14-0 Fontainebleau, 4:01 to go, first quarter. Olivier to kick it off after he made his second extra point and put the Bulldogs up 14-0 over the Bonnabel Bruins here in the first quarter. 13th season on Channel 13. This one going left side, going to be picked up and runned out by Kadarius Bryant. He's going to get bottled up and brought down. Robert Celentano in on the stop. Bruins will take over, Hunter, about their 28-yard line.
And Coach Rogers has to get his team going now. He can't fall behind any further with Fontainebleau looking as good as they have so far on the offensive side of the ball.
Samaj Franklin looking. Gonna sprint out to his left. He's gonna duck it and run. Tuck it and run. Well, he's gonna be ducking it pretty soon, right? And he's shut down over there. Nice little pickup of about 4 on that one. Second down and 6 for the Bruins. And right now, Coach Rogers will take anything that's positive from the offensive, from his offense. Fake handoff and keep on the left side, up the left sideline. There he goes, Samaj Franklin, and Bonnabel answers in 2 plays.
What a play there by Franklin. Did you see that block on the sideline just got laid out, and once that happened, Franklin broke free and nobody was gonna catch him.
Not up that sideline. Good fake on the inside, and Samaj put on the speed burners up the sideline. And Bonnabel answers the Bulldogs touchdown with a 2-play drive. Extra point about to come as the Bruins. Luis Mejia. Oh, it's a fake. They're going for 2. Quick pass, incomplete. Franklin had all kinds of options right there. He could pitch it or he could throw it. Decides to throw it.
Yeah, it might have been better for him to take off with it there. Good coverage there by Fontainebleau there, but there is a flag on the field.
Yeah, that's the old swinging gate right there. And it was no good. They said illegal procedure. They didn't get in anyway, so no need for the penalty. So swinging gate play from Coach Rogers. And it does not pay off. So, 2:58 to go, first quarter, 14-6. So, Mejia will kick off following a failed 2-point attempt out of the swinging gate. This one deep. Bastion gonna get it right around the 10-yard line on the return. Cuts it back to the middle and drug down right away at the 20-yard line. Nice special teams play right there.
Yeah, that's a really good tackle. Fontainebleau has started with great field position the last 2 times out. Now they're going to have a long way to go if they want to punch it in again.
Well, we're going to see if they can keep that offense churning. They're 2 of 3 on drives. with a turnover. So they're either very, very good or very bad. It's the ups and downs of the first game of the season, and in particular, the first quarter. Blocker, handoff inside. Nice move by Marquez to kind of cut it out a little bit. Then he's wrapped up by a whole host of Bruins.
Bulldogs are still doing a pretty good job of mixing it up and keeping the Bruins down back on their heels so far.
Yeah, 4 yards on that pickup. That's where you want to be, 4 or 5 yards on first or more on first down. All right. Second down, 6. We've just been served fried Oreos as the Bulldogs pick up a first down. It don't get much better than this, folks. At Fountain Blue High, you got to go to the concession stand to get fried Oreos. Where do they have this in America? Are you kidding me? Oh. Oh. Thank you to Principal Johnny Vetrano. Back to the action. Blocker. 3-step drop. Got a man. Complete. That one, a nice pitch and catch to Whitney Duplantis up the right sideline.
And the secondary just lost Duplantis there. He was wide open. There was nobody anywhere close.
Excuse me as I take another bite. Oh, this is unreal. That's why you need to be out on Friday nights at these high school football games. And if you can't, you're going to catch it on 13. Rolling left. Blocker. Oh, almost picked. That one was ripe for the picking right there. A good effort and a good break by Evante Williams defensively, and almost picked it off.
Yeah, and that was a really dangerous pass there, and it's always scary when the ball gets tipped up in the air like that. Everybody holds their breath waiting to see what happens. But another break there for the Bulldogs.
Well, I didn't hold my breath. I'm still eating this fried Oreo. Second down, 10 now. Blitz coming. Hand off up the middle. I should say right side was Marquez. And they're getting that yardage that I talked about, that 4, 5, 6 yards on first down, which makes second and third easier picking.
Yeah, it definitely does. It's nice not to have that pressure of having to throw it for 10 yards every time on third down. And that's what's kind of helped them keep the ball moving.
Third down and 7 now. Block. Screen coming. Inside. Complete. Sisong breaks one tackle and picks up the first time. That time they went with the jailbreak screen, and Sisong, Cole Sisong, breaks up inside, gets a couple of blocks on the outside, first down.
And a good play by Blocker there to get that one off. The big defensive lineman, number 47, Darius Price, got in the backfield quickly there and put a lot of pressure on him. But somehow was able to get that screen off and get the first down.
Blocker has been calm under pressure so far. First down, 10. Motion by Marquez. Faked it and keeps it himself. Wow. Boy, the Bruins bit on that one, didn't they?
Yeah, they definitely did. And that's something that Blocker has done really well so far, is with the fake, kind of tricked everybody out again on that one. And he's done a really good job with that so far tonight.
Little read option, right? That was a little read option and speed option, I should say, because he came across the formation. And that's going to end the first quarter with the Fountain Blue Bulldogs up 14-6. Over the Bonnabel Bruins, and they're driving.
St. Tammany Parish Public Schools. an A-rated school district. Graduates with the highest ACT scores in the state. Facilities with the latest technology. Safe and secure schools. A variety of sports. Fine arts. And learning to last a lifetime.
I'm Superintendent Trey Foles, and this is where we educate every child, every day.
Both teams have switched ends of the field. Second down and four after that play. Pump fake, got a man wide open. Oh, broken up over there by Kadarius Bryant. I thought he kind of hung that one a little bit.
Yeah, he did. Bastion was wide open, but that one stayed up too far, gave the defender time to get over there and put a big hit on him and bust it loose.
Kadarius Bryant, 5'10", 165 from Bonnabel. Nice play right there to break that one up. But they faked the jailbreak screen and went with the blocker going long. And I think he just put a little too much air under that one.
Yeah, he did. Bastion was right there, almost held on to it, but that was a huge hit.
Third down and three. I formation. Hand off. Right side. Running for a first down and then some. That time they closed down to two tights with a strong I formation to the right, handed it off that way, and boom, got big yardage and a first down.
Yeah, Marquez was darting in between the big offensive linemen there, just sneaking his way through for a big gain. And another first down for the Bulldogs.
First and 10 now, motion by Marquez. We got a flag. Somebody moved. Blocker. It went nowhere.
Blocker carries the ball. There's a marker on the play.
That play didn't even get out the gate. There was a penalty right up from the beginning. I'm going to say illegal procedure as that motion started before everybody was set. Oh, that's illegal shift. So, penalty marked off. So it'll be first and 15 now for the Bulldogs. See the play where they faked, before they got the first down, they faked the jailbreak and went long. That was set up by the fact they had gotten 7 yards, third and three, and now you can waste a down and then come back and run for the first down. So. Just missed on that one. Great play by Bryant. Three-step drop. Blocker under pressure. Dumped. Good defensive pressure. Number 34, Devontae Martin with the play.
And Blocker had nowhere to go with that one. The offensive line just imploded, and Martin got there back there so quickly.
So a promising drive is stalling out here. And we'll see. It's second down and about 20. Blocker. Middle screen. Marquez avoids one tackler and cuts it up. And gets about 7 or 8 yards back.
Yeah, he had a couple options in that play. Bastion was out in the flat, he could have gone out there as well.
Third down now, and 15. Blocker dropping, no pressure this time. That one, he just didn't get it there. Never really set his feet to throw that one. The curl was breaking under, and we're going to have Olivier come out to attempt a long field goal. You had a chance to look at Tyler in practice field goal wise. What do you Look like he might have it. He might have the leg. This is going to be, this will be 33 yard line, 43 yard field goal.
Yeah, he was nearly hitting them from 50 yards in practice. We'll see what he can do here.
Snap. This one, knuckleball, nowhere near. But I think we have a penalty. I think somebody on the defensive end is going to give Olivier a second chance. Foul offsides. There you go. There's a foul against Bonnabel. They'll give another chance.
And that's a big break for Olivier and the Bulldogs, because now they get to move the ball a little closer. And, you know, the Bruins don't get quite such good field position to start the drive.
I can remember a game when I coached at Covington. We played Lutcher, and we attempted a field goal and missed. They committed a foul. We got a second chance and ended up kicking that field goal and winning the game. You cannot make mistakes. There's another guy that jumps. He'll get another chance if they declare this one no good. So we'll... 5 yards for infringement. Olivier's getting some practice here. That one looked like it had the, well, maybe it was blown dead. That's the only thing I can think. It was blown dead. He was, they blew it dead. Otherwise, they would have looked at that. Now we're at the 23-yard. It's a 33-yard field goal. Hey, you give him enough chances, he'll knock it through. Tyler Olivier gets one from 33 yards. 9:34 to go, first half, 17-6. Bulldogs over the visiting Bonnabel Bruins. Olivier to kick it off after that big field goal by him.
It's a touchback.
And it's a touchback, so. Bonnabel will take over, first down 10 at their own 20-yard line.
You know Coach Rogers has to be frustrated after that last defensive possession. Your offense has just gone down the field, got your first score of the game, and the momentum started to shift. You come up with a stop on defense, and then you commit two penalties on the field goal to give them a third try to make it in.
They missed two field goal attempts, which would have been no points. You'd have got football back. Now they get three, extend their lead. Franklin, no, check that. Sonny Tyner trying to make it around the corner, and he's wrapped up by a whole kennel of Bulldogs. Cal Babin among them.
And an interesting choice to make the switch at quarterback right now by Coach Rogers. Franklin had just driven down the field and gotten them in the end zone on a long run.
He might still be winded on the sideline. Who knows? Tyner. This one through his hands. Down around the one. Uh-oh! More importantly, he didn't get it. Turnover. Bulldogs. Number 85, Christian Maroney, 6'5", 250 junior, gets the ball, and whoa, like you said, he takes Franklin out, puts Tyner in, nothing on the first play, the next play goes right through his hands.
He's got to be kicking himself on the sideline now for that. Tyner had a little rust, that one just went right by him, and now Fontainebleau doesn't have long to go to extend this lead again.
Bulldog offense back out on the field. Back in that power eye stack to the right side. Hunt Thompson at quarterback, hands off. And we have a touchdown with Marquez. Kendrick Marquez takes it in. One play drive from about 3 yards. Olivier, who just kicked a 33-yard field goal, is back out to attempt an extra point. Some confusion on the Bruins side about extra point people. Kick up, and it's good. 8:38 to go, first half, 24-6. The Fontainebleau Bulldogs over the Bonnabel Bruins. Olivier to kick it off. Olivier has 6 points in the game, 3 extra points and a field goal. This one high and deep, down around the 4-yard line. Breaking one tackle, then another up the middle. One man to beat. Touchdown.
Kadarius Bryant returns it.
Kadarius Bryant. Well, he ran
take
out
a little spill.
Take a little spill at the end, but hey, what a way to answer. You know, I keep thinking, okay, wait a minute, the Bruins are gonna be now, they're gonna be out of this. And they find a way, this time special team-wise. He was hit twice.
Yeah, that was just a gift.
Yeah, I mean, hey, he kept churning. He was hit twice. And I would say you probably would think he had to go down, but he did not go down. And so it's going to be a problem now for, you can see the Bruins don't have enough people on the field for the extra point. Ooh, speaking of that, a Bulldog is late arriving also. Well, one from each side late to the party. Mejia to attempt the extra point. Snap there, kick up, looks good. And it is good. 8:21 to go first half, 24-13. The Bruins clawing their way back. Mejia to put it back in play. And he drives it deep, and it's in play. Bastion on the return. Steps out of one tackle, but then wrapped up across the 20-yard line, down around the 23. So we've had, that was about a 96-yard kickoff return. And we had a long run by Samaj Franklin. And a little shorter distances for the Bulldogs, but they've been steadily moving the football.
And I think that's a good sign early on for them to, you know, they're using the spread offense and they're keeping things moving.
First down, 10, Fontainebleau, motion by Bastion. Snap, rolling right. Thompson, almost picked off. Hunt Thompson on the rollout is almost picked off.
Yeah, and so his first pass of the game, you know, showing a little rust right there, almost getting it picked off on that first play coming in for blocker.
Blocker is standing up on the sidelines. It appears that coach, as coach said pregame, he hadn't really decided. He went with blocker to start with, but he's giving Thompson a chance here.
Yeah, and up by a couple of possessions, you know, it's not too bad of an idea to get Thompson in there to see what he can do now that he's had blocker under center.
Second down, 10. Quick pass out for Bastion. Makes one guy miss. Cuts it back up to the outside and is dumped. Got some yards on that one. They're saying turnover. The Bruins are pointing turnover. Guess what? It is. Bonnabel with a fumble on that completion to Bastion. And the Bruins will take over in great field position. They've got possession in a good position. How's that? At the 30-yard line.
Coach Matern has to be sweating now. He was just up by 18 points, 2 minutes ago. And now, things are getting a little too close for comfort.
Samaj Franklin back in at quarterback. Handoff inside. Nice run up the middle. Cuts it out to the outside and still going down inside the 10-yard line. Maurice Britton. Wow. Yeah, right now, this is not what the Bulldogs want to see. First down, 10 at the 9.
And that was almost a touchdown. Will Wajda just got a hand in there at the last second to bring him down by his shoelaces.
Franklin calling for the motion. Handoff inside, cutting it back. Gaping hole, touchdown. Bonnabel went right back to the well. It was good enough for one big gainer. They went right back to Britton.
Yeah, and I think Coach Rogers realized that the switch to Sonny Tyner wasn't a smart one after that last play that, had them fumble the ball at the 2-yard line on the last possession. So now going with what he knows, Franklin pounding that one in again for another touchdown, and we got a close game again.
24-19 now. Mahia on to get the Bruins within four. And heck, there's 7:28 to go in the first half still. This kick is up and it is good. 24-20 with 7:28 to go. First half, Fontainebleau's lead evaporating. There have been no shortage of exciting plays in the last couple of minutes here. Man, if you got up and went to the refrigerator for some pizza or, tried to microwave or something, forget it, people. It went from 24-6 to 24-17, I don't know, 24-20. Look at this move. Look at this run. Man, there has been no shortage of those kinds of plays. Bastion with a great return brings it back out to about the 46-yard line.
Here's where you have to capitalize if you're Bonnabel, because you have great field position. If you're Fontainebleau, because Bonnabel has been driving, has been pounding it in, and that lead, like you said, has evaporated. So they have to make something happen on this drive.
First down, 10. From the 47. Dropping is Thompson. Tipped. Almost picked off. They got the linebacker dropped in coverage right there and was able to get, they were throwing the deep ball, was able to get a hand on it, knock it away.
And if you're Coach Rogers, I think you have to be really happy with how your defense has performed so far. Even though you're down by four, you forced a couple of turnovers. You almost picked off three other passes. So, they're still in this game.
Absolutely. Second down, 10. Thompson. From the pistol. Looking, dropping. Scrambling. Pulls up, delivers the pass, incomplete. Flag on the field. We're gonna have a holding call, I believe. Holding against Fontainebleau. Decline brings up third down and 10.
And Thompson has been flushed out of the pocket on those past couple of plays and had to make throws on the run, and he's made some dangerous throws because of that. So the front line needs to do a better job of blocking on this third down so that Fontainebleau can try to get a first down out of it.
I'm smelling one of those jailbreak screens right here. Right here, I'm looking for Atlantis to come underneath. Nope. They go the other way, and we got a penalty, though. I don't know if that's pass interference. That one was intended for Sisson. Incomplete.
Yeah, Sisson was just sandwiched in between two defenders, and Thompson flung it over there. It may be pass interference.
Maybe it wasn't catchable. I don't know. They're having that discussion right now. Oh, chop block is what it was called. Wow, not pass interference. I knew that ball wasn't too close. Wasn't it catchable, I didn't think. So it's going to bring up fourth down, punting situation. Wow. Lots of time left in the first half. And again, special team situations, people not being on the field. Both teams have had this problem. Punting, extra points, first game of the year. Snap there, Olivier. High kick, fair caught by Kadarius Bryant. But the ball will be at about the 21-yard line. First down, 10 for Bonnabel.
The Bruins have caused a lot of havoc on special teams. A good job right there with a big booming punt with a lot of hang time. Gave special teams time to get down there and get the fair catch.
First down, 10 now. Handoff inside. That one's going nowhere. Ball on the ground, fumble. And a recovery. By the Bulldogs. Big time play there. Tyner was back out at quarterback. And he hands it off, and there's a fumble. But the Bulldogs in great field position. At about the 22-yard line.
And every time it starts to look like somebody's taking control of the game and going to make something happen, you know, a ball gets coughed up or a big play gets called back.
I was reading something today. I don't remember if it was in the internet or on the paper. And somebody said that seasons have momentums up and down. Games have. There's a wide open man. Bastion, touchdown. As they fake the screen out there, and Bastion roll it up the sideline, and Hunt Thompson put it on there. And before I could even get with my ups and downs, we have another up. Like momentum is what it was said. Momentum, I think Coach Sean Payton said it. The season will have momentum, and games will have momentum. In fact, quarters will have momentum. And it's been back and forth right now. The Bulldogs have seized back Big Mo. Olivier. Good. 6:35 to go, first half. 31-20. We've had 51 points in the first half, and there's still 6.5 minutes to go. So basically, three quarters of the first half, 51 points. Olivier will kick it off. How many times have I said that? Huh? In the, under the Department of Redundancy Department, this is it. Bryant cuts up the middle. No 97-yard return that time.
Yeah, good job of wrapping him up and keeping him from cutting back to the outside. He wanted to get back out to the sideline, but a great job to do it before he could get over there.
You could tell that, you know, he's been playing defense, and now he's going back to, and he ran that big kick. He was kind of like, it's been a hot first half. He was thinking to himself, wow. I need a break. If I see an opening, I'll sprint through it, but I need a break.
I mean, and neither one of these teams has put together a long drive since the first drive of the game for the Bulldogs, so the defense has been on the field for a long time.
Samaj Franklin back out on the field as Tyner's had a short stint that last time. Franklin, handoff, right side. And that was Brian, I think. Basically what, that, no, it's not Brian, it's number eight. It looks like three. It's Raquan Hart. Hart with a run out and around the edge, got no yards, second down 10.
Yeah, and I don't know if we'll see Tyner again in this game after the two possessions he's had so far. Fumbles on both.
The last one I don't think was his fault. And we got a timeout. 6 minutes to go in the first half. 31-20, Fontainebleau. No, it's not a basketball game. Fontainebleau over Bonnabel. Second down 10, Franklin dropping, lots of time. Heaves one long, looks like a wounded duck, and come back. Are we gonna, no, we're gonna say incomplete.
Franklin's pass intended for
Alfred Richardson tried to come back to get that one. I think we're gonna have a holding call on Fontainebleau.
I don't know, it may have looked like a little bit of a push-off there.
Oh, was it a push-off by?
By Bonnabel.
By Bonnabel. You're gonna talk it over. Pass interference. That's gonna be a 15-yard penalty. The ball will be about the 45-yard line. It might have been there, he was holding him back. The hometown fans disagree.
And that's what that size of Richardson, 6'3", will do for you against the smaller defensive backs. They did everything they could to keep him from catching it, and it was just a little too much.
Ball at the check it 46-yard line, first down 10. Franklin threw up a wounded duck last time. This one, handoff inside. Straight ahead, that's gonna be a nice pickup of about seven. Gonna bring up second down and three. Again, like Fontainebleau when they were moving the football. If you get 7 yards, 5, 6, 7 yards on first down, you could do something on second down they're not expecting.
Yeah, and the way Bonneville's offense works, you're gonna need to get those because you don't wanna be having long third down plays in an offense that's not designed for a lot of passing.
So second down now, Franklin. Fake handoff, he's gonna keep it himself. He's gonna have a first down. Gonna cut out to the sideline and run out of bounds. Oh, there's gonna be a flag. He was pulled down once, no flag?
Pushed out of bounds by number 34, Travis.
Yeah, it looked like he was pulled down by his collar.
Yeah, it looked, well, out of bounds more than anything.
Yeah.
So, well, no. No flag, no foul. First down 10, Bruins. Samaj Franklin, inside pass. Little jailbreak screen out over there for Wenzie. Goes too high, incomplete. Bring up second down 10 for the Bruins.
And that's a throw that he needs to make. He could have at least gotten 2, 3, 4 yards on that play, but now it's gonna be a long second down and 10.
That one just floated over his head. Didn't bury that front shoulder down and follow through. Seven seconds on the play clock. Option Franklin pitches it out there, and that one's going to be blown up over there. Will Wadja with a nice play over there along with Mason Hornsby.
Yeah, they had that play sniffed out from the very beginning, and they got there quickly to bring them down for a loss. So now a really long third down.
Third down and 11. We were talking about them having second down and 3 in the last series, when they got their last first down. Now, kind of going back the other way.
You don't want Franklin to beat you with his legs here.
Going deep down the middle, got a man, complete. Wow.
What a throw by Franklin.
Right to Denzel Winsey as he went right up the hash marks in the seam. And guess what? Franklin put it right in his numbers. Man, this may be one of the longest first halves as far as scoring. We've had 51 points, and there's still 4 minutes to go. Bruins knocking on the door. I formation. Handoff left side. They're down around the goal line, around the 2 yard line.
Stop by number 12, back 44, Stacy, and 7, Real Vida. Second and goal from the 3.
Ball on the 3 yard line. They're going with a little heavy situation right here. I formation, two tights. Franklin, handoff, left side. That one's blown up and not going to go in. I think they should have bootlegged it with Franklin. Fake that handoff and bootleg it with him. Let the wide receiver go out, so it's him and the wide receiver.
Yeah, and Franklin's showing what kind of damage he can do with his legs, and Fontainebleau needs a big stop right here after that deflating third down and 12.
Third and 3 now at the 3. 2:38 to go and ticking. 31-20. Bruins trying to get claw back. They haven't stopped clawing, I know that. I formation. Quick pass, floater up there. Touchdown. Yes, it is. So they go with the fade pass.
For the score, Franklin to Richardson. There's a marker on the play.
Alfred Richardson on the reception.
There's a flag down.
There's a flag. We're going to have pass interference.
A penalty against Bonnabel.
I think so. It looked to me like there was a little hands on there by Richardson.
Holding penalty against Bonnabel.
Oh, holding against Bonnabel. It's almost unbelievable. That was a one-step throw.
Yeah.
It's like, how did they have time to hold? I don't know. Hey.
Nope. Down and goal from the 13.
They're going to have to try to do it again now. Still third down, though. Third and 13.
And Franklin knew his matchup that he had on the outside there. Richardson has a full 8 inches on Gavin Scholl on the outside, so...
No problem, I guess. So, Franklin, they're going to go back to that guy in the seam again. Watch. No? Handoff in the middle.
Britton tries to run up the middle.
I got a question mark about that play. Not sure why they were doing that and why you did that. They thought they were going to catch everybody off a guard.
No game.
Off guard, but didn't happen.
Fourth
and 13 now.
Luis Mejia trying field goal.
That's what they wanted to do. They lined it up for Mejia to attempt a field goal. This one will be a 30-yarder.
30-yard attempt for Mejia.
Kick, no, not going to get there.
Partially blown.
So the Bulldogs hold.
Take over
after the Bruins got a holding penalty. Wow, there's momentum shifts within series, within plays, play to play.
Yeah,
crazy.
You had that big play downfield on 3rd and 12 by Franklin to get down inside the 10, and then you're about to punch it in. You punch it in, except there's a holding call. And
now you got nothing. A 31-27 get possible game is still 31-20. Kudos to the defensive Bulldogs.
Yeah, definitely. They stood strong there, and they made the plays when they needed to.
First down, 10. Hunt Thompson, empty backfield, motion him back, going to be option. Pitches out to Bastion, trying to make the corner. Does, and runs out of bounds. 1:28 to go in the half. And the Bulldogs are not happy with just 31 points. They're looking for a little bit more.
And Hunt Thompson looked a lot better on that last possession. He was shaky his first couple of times out, trying to make some throws on the run. But on that last touchdown pass, the last time he was out there, he planted his feet, fired it in there to give them an 11-point lead. And now they can expand on that before half. Plenty of time left with just under a minute and a half to go.
Thompson dropping, looking, going to deliver over the middle, almost picked off.
That might have been a late hit there.
Didn't call it. Didn't happen in that case. Devin Jacobs on the coverage. The linebacker almost got his hands on that. As we found out early in this game that Fontainebleau's not afraid to throw the ball long. Play coming in from the sideline. Motion by Bastion. Thompson drop, looking, scrambling, going to be pulled down. Wounded duck thrown up, incomplete, almost picked off.
Now, that was a good play by Noah Gear there to go in defensive mode and make sure that play doesn't get intercepted, so now you have a chance to punt it away.
I think that would have been a time where Thompson should have put it away, tucked it away and taken the loss.
Yeah.
I mean, that was close. But like you said, a great play by Greer to break it up.
Yeah, and if you go down there, you force Bonnabel to burn another timeout if they want to try to get it in the end zone again.
Olivier to punt. Snap there. Booms this one. Fair catch. Ball about the 47-yard line. Believe it or not, I don't know how long you've been with us so far. First half still has a minute six to go. We've had 51 points, almost 57, 58 points. That one wiped off, but no shortage of excitement, that's for sure.
No shortage of excitement, no shortage of turnovers, no shortage of penalties so far in there.
Welcome to the first game of the year.
See if Franklin airs it out here.
He does, inside.
Whoa.
Boom. Big hit right there. Kyle Babin, the 6'2", 195-pound junior, said, "You are not going any further," as he lowered his shoulder.
Thompson, and now Babin's slow to get up, though. He's grabbing his leg.
The clock was readjusted, 49 seconds to go in the half. Franklin, under pressure, steps up, throws one up, almost picked off. Brennan Kent reached up and knocked it away from one of his own teammates. He didn't know it was back there, ready to pick it off.
Yeah, that's a break for Bonnabel. There's no reason that one shouldn't have been an interception. Cole Sisong was back there waiting for it.
You could almost say, hear him say, me, I got it. Only to have his teammate knock it down. pass in and out of the hands of the intended receiver. They ran a little rollout read screen. If the guy doing the curl right there that he threw the ball, if he was covered, then he would have stopped. The back ran up the sideline. He would have dumped it off to the back. As it was, he threw it to the curl man who was open. He just didn't make the play. It's going to bring up fourth down now, 36 seconds to go. A punt about to happen. Maybe. Mejia drives one. That's caught by Bastion, trying to make it to the sideline. He does! One guy to beat, no! No, he had someone trailing him to make the tackle. A really nice play on the other sideline by a Bruin defender to get him from behind. Otherwise, he had Mejia to beat, and I there's no doubt he would have gone by him.
So now decision time for Coach Matern. Do you run out the clock, say goodbye to this first half that's been crazy, you know, take a breather, or do you go and try to run up the score a little more, get a bigger lead before halftime?
Oh, yeah. They're going to go. The way they're lined up, Thompson back out there. They're not in the old victory formation, which would mean they would take a knee, so I don't see that happening. They're going for it. Thompson dropping, looking. Looks one way, throws back the other. Jailbreak screen, still going. Sisson got it down to about the 30-yard line. Wow.
And that's a really good play there. A lot of good blocks.
We got timeout. We have a timeout. 14 seconds to go in this first half. 31-20. Fontainebleau over Bonnabel and driving. Seconds to go after the timeout. Thompson dropping. Time. Looks long. Pass. Incomplete. No flag on the play.
Yeah, Thompson just threw that one up there into a group of defenders and receivers, and nobody really had a chance to catch that one. Everybody got tangled up.
It was a mini Hail Mary right there. 7 seconds to go. And we're going to have another timeout by the Bulldogs. If you haven't had enough of this first half, we're going to have a timeout. And we'll have another second, 7 seconds, in just a minute. Last play of the half possible. Of course, there's always a penalty or something crazy. We've seen a lot of it in the first half of 2014. Dropping, Thompson under pressure, and that one's gonna go out.
We'll have another play.
We'll have another play. We're down to what, how many seconds?
2 seconds left to go.
Two seconds. Tyler Olivier back out.
I mean, he's got a good leg, but this is a long field goal attempt, I think.
Yeah, this one would be, he didn't get it close when he went from this yardage before. Well, I will tell you what I like, though. Coach Matern is giving him plenty of opportunities, yeah. Right?
Yeah, he's definitely put his faith in his kicker.
38-yard line, 48-yard field goal from Olivier to end the half. Bad snap. Olivier, better fall on it. He does, and that, we've seen it all in the first half. But the Bulldogs of Fontainebleau are up 31-20 at the half.
Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome to the Crimson Band from Bulldog Land. The drum majors this year are Cameron Field and Brian McGill. The percussion captain, Bradley Gonzalez.
front ensemble captain, Kevin Drez. The color guard captains include Camille LeBlanc, Natalie Hart, Julia Racy, Lucy Quavis, and Jojo Hagen. Escort captains Emily Byrne and Alexis Schultz. This year's halftime show is entitled Fast Track. Tonight the band will perform movement one, Land Track.
If I could, I surely would stand on a rock for more than two. Move for the stage line. Move for the stage line. Move for the stage line. Yeah, we go line and back. Maybe the baby's lying in the shade, thinking on the money that I ain't made. Move for the stage line. Move for the stage line. Move for the stage line.
Thank you.
Well, the long first half in the books. Second half underway with Olivier's kickoff. This one is going to be a touchback. Whew, man, I've caught my breath now, Hunter. Pretty big first half scoring-wise.
Yeah, it was. And, you know, it's not like any one offense was performing well. A lot of turnovers for both sides, a lot of penalties from both sides. So hopefully, you know, coming out here in the second half, they can put things together a little bit and start clicking, shake some of the rust off from the offseason.
I mean, I don't know that you could – I don't know if I've had a game that 31-20 at the half. It could have been 31-28, and then, well, then Bonnabel didn't even make a field goal, so it's been crazy.
Yeah.
You know, it's just been crazy. Second half now, everybody's rested. Franklin hands off right side. And a couple of yards on the carry right there. That was number 8, Raquan Hart, on the carry.
And for the most part, Fontainebleau has done a good job of containing the run in that first half. Besides a couple of long runs from Samaj Franklin, the quarterback, they've done a pretty good job with the running game of Bonnabel.
Yeah, Britton had a couple of runs and got a touchdown. But other than that, the run has been stuffed. We saw more passes, hence the stopping of play. Samaj Franklin. Woo.
Helmets off.
Racked up.
Ooh. Ooh.
We got a timeout on the field. Franklin throws out and over the intended receiver's head out there. Going to bring up fourth down.
And Coach Matern has to be encouraged by the way his defense came out and played on that first drive. Did a good job of stuffing the run and stopping the pass when they had to.
Mahia on to punt it away. Punt underway, end over end. That one's dropped by Bastion, and he's immediately hit there, but great field position. They had a return on, I think, Hunter. Bastion got going before he got the ball.
Yeah, he took the eye off the ball, started to run before he had even hit his hands, and just a good job there to turn around and fall down on top of it to keep another turnover here just over a minute into the second half.
Ball out at the 47-yard line, first down 10 for the Bulldogs. They're coming out. See, the ball's set for play. The play clock should be running. It has not been blown in to start running it. Don't get it. All right.
Looks like Mason Blocker's back out there.
Yep, start the second half. Pitch back to Bastion, and that play's blown up. Nice defensive play.
And I know coming into this game, Coach Matern didn't know who he wanted to start at quarterback, and I still don't think anything's been done to answer those questions. Both Blocker and Thompson have had really good moments, and then they both had really bad moments too.
So it's going to be second down and about 20 after the option play goes awry. Snap goes right by everybody. They got to fall on it. It's going to be third down at about 30. So I'm not sure that Coach Matern wanted to start the second half this way offensively. So much success in the first half, and you start the second by going backwards on the first two plays.
Yeah, and it's really discouraging, especially because your defense just came out, made a big stop, and you have a chance to come out and put some points on the board, but go in the wrong direction.
Blocker, fake, gonna run it. Gets tripped up, gets about 3 or 4 yards, and they're gonna have to punt it away.
Yeah, punting it away here in this position, in this possession might not be the worst thing, considering you muff the punt coming out, and then you almost fumble it over your head. You know, and if that would have been recovered by Bonnabel, it would have been inside the 15-yard line. So, punt not the worst thing that could happen.
Olivier on to punt it. High snap, but he gets it, and he booms it. High floater, fair catch, and that one's going to take a weird bounce and going to be touched down there by Bo Turner on the special teams. And that ball is at the 48-yard line. So great field position. All right, a stop on the first possession. You get it. You go backwards. Now the other team's got great field position.
Yeah, and the Bruins came out flat on that first possession in the second half. So we'll see if Franklin can get something moving and get this running game going. Actually, is that Sonny Tyner back out there?
It looks like Tyner. He keeps it. He's going to be wrapped up, and he barely gets back to the line of scrimmage. Malik Dennis. Excuse me, not Malik Dennis. Chase Mundell and Kyle Babin combine with some other Bulldogs to make the stop, second down and 10. Yeah, if your running game is not going, and Coach Rogers mentioned this, if it's not going, then his team's not going, and they've had their tough times with it. Handoff inside. And that was Maurice Britton again. The sophomore running back, 5'8", 170, got positive yardage. Going to bring up third down and 6 for the Bruins.
Third down 6 for the Bruins.
Yeah, and a good job to just get a few yards there and make this third down a little more manageable.
For you that may head out to the airport in New Orleans, you will know Bonnabel High School. They're right off of I-10, right off on the right. They're sticking out. And there's a bad snap. Tyner can't get it. Loose ball. But they retained possession. It's going to bring up fourth down. So in the first half, Hunter, offenses having their way. And the early part of the second half, the defenses. So adjustments at halftime.
Yeah, and I mean, it's like we were talking about earlier in the first half, things changed so quickly. And, you know, they certainly did in the 20-minute break for halftime.
Snap, Mahia. Fair catch, loose ball. Well, we've certainly had, it's going to be Fontainebleau ball.
A lucky break there.
Alex Brossette comes up with the loose ball that Sisson fumbled. And one thing about the special teams tonight, both teams, it's kind of been a mystery.
Yeah.
It's kind of been a mystery to unfold in each time. All right, second possession, second half, Bulldogs. Mason Blocker, motion. Gonna fake the handoff. He's keeping himself running the football. Gonna get the first down and more. That's a little spark of what we saw in the first half from Blocker, who kind of really got the Bulldogs going.
And I think that's when he's been at his best and when he's looked the most comfortable is whenever he's faking the handoff and getting outside and making defenders miss.
Little speed option there. Gets a first down for the Bulldogs. Ball out to the 45-yard line. You know, I almost feel as long as the first half was that we almost played a whole game in the first half. And this is almost like overtime. And it's a little more subdued, a slower pace. There's a run straight ahead by Marquez. Kendrick Marquez. Second down, 6 for the Bulldogs.
And I really like the Bulldogs are coming out here and running a little more to start out the second half. I think that's a good change of pace because a lot of passes thrown in the first half, and I think this is a good way to mix things up a little bit.
And we have a timeout on the field. And I've got to say it's a heat and humidity timeout. Timeout. 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. We're still 31-20, Fontainebleau over Bonnabel. Back from the heat and humidity timeout. Man, that's a mouthful. Handoff inside. Marquez, good yardage. Going to bring up third and short. Much better job kind of running the football early part of the third quarter.
Like we said, a lot more manageable third downs, and you really can go anywhere from here. I'd like to see another option from blocker. Let him use his legs again.
They're going to go one tight end, I formation, blown up.
Oh, wow.
Good defensive play, number 57, Marcus Martin. Double M, Marcus Martin blew up that play. He said, I'm not having any of that. They put that play away. Going to bring up fourth down and a punting situation.
Yeah, I said they could go anywhere with that play, but that wasn't the way to go.
Wow.
I've been impressed with Olivier's punts tonight.
Very high. And pretty much unreturnable. And it's touchdown there. And we'll be put back in play by the Bruins. First down, Franklin, inside screen, complete.
And in pregame, we talked a lot about how this was a running team, but it seems like in the first half and then so far here in the second half, it's been more a lot of short screens, quick passes, you know, to the sideline that have been more the way that they've run this offense.
I think they got behind. I think they pushed away from that. They did have some success in the first half running the football, but they got away from it. Franklin, nice pitch and catch. Coming back for the football there is number 5, Joshua Crocklin. Good reception.
And the last few times that Franklin has rolled out like that, he's pulled the ball in and run with it.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I want to check that out. That was Alfred Richardson. The numbers are hard to read here on the screen. Yeah, that puts pressure on the defense when he pulls it up. This is Britton trying to make the corner. He evades one and almost the second one. Tackled over there by Travis Sears. And we have another timeout on the field. 31-20, 3:26 to go, third quarter, Fontainebleau over Bonnabel. Okay. From the pistol, handoff inside. Britton gets the first down and then some. Heading up the sideline, breaks the tackle. He gets the ball coming to his left. So everybody thinks he's going left, and then he cuts back, kind of that read option play, and then cuts back against the grain. So the linemen are all pushing towards their left. He's stepping to their left. Fontainebleau's overcompensating to their right. He cuts back and runs by him.
Yeah, he has a lot of speed out of his cuts. As soon as he makes that cut, he explodes down the sideline.
Franklin going deep on this one. Got a man. Oh! He knows he should have had that one. Wow. I think that was Wenzie. Denzel Wenzie.
Yeah, he's definitely mad at himself for that one. When you're down by two possessions in the second half, you have the chance to make a play like that. You have to make it.
I tell you what, Coach Rogers is not afraid to air it out with the long ball once in a while.
And whenever you have the running game working well like they do right now, that's something you can start to do a little more.
And that one did not work. Good defense there. Chase Mundell. Mundell, 6'3", 250, a senior. Just came, collided down in there, shut that play down. Pick up of about a half a yard. We'll call it net gain of zero. Third down and 10. Samaj Franklin, he can make things happen. Low snap, rolls out, fakes the run, pulls up, and throws it. Intended over there for number 81 for Mejia. Luis Mejia is double duty tonight. He's not only the punter and kicker, he's over there at wide receiver. Fourth down. I don't see a punt coming here. Two touchdowns down. Getting close to the end of the third quarter. Got to do something, a little motion. Franklin resets the receiver, drops back, looks over the middle, inside screen, and incomplete. Intended for Richardson. And the Bulldog defense steps up right there and snuffs out the drive.
Yeah, really impressive job by them so far in this first half. They've bent a lot, but they haven't broken yet. And I think that's good when you're up by 11.
Handoff blocker up the middle. Busting through Marquez. Gonna get hauled down there by Taylor Ross, but not until he got big yardage. Now, here's the funny thing. We were talking about the spread opening the game, right? They're throwing the football. Bonnabel's supposed to be the running team, but here in the second half, the Bulldogs are finding some space running the football.
And I think part of the reason for that is that they did throw so much in the first half, so it's opening up some of those running lanes because they're trying to defend the pass.
Quick snap here. Marquez trying to make the corner and goes out of bounds. Looked like the Bulldogs a little more of a little hurry up this time.
And I think that's good. You have a defense that's out there tiring. It's hot. It's humid. You know, you're deep in the second half of a game after a two-hour-long first half. I think this is a good way to go to try to put some points on the board.
Motion. Play fake. Complete pass. that time he threaded it in there to Bastion. So a nice pitch and catch from Blocker to Bastion.
Yeah, Bastion was surrounded by three defenders, but Blocker just squeezed it right in there. Things are starting to move for the Bulldogs.
Marquez, fake handoff, Blocker up the middle. A lot of mileage out of that play. I'm going to say when it's all over with, he's got probably close to 50 yards running off of just that play.
Yeah. Yeah, busted it off for a couple of big gains in the first half. Haven't gone to it as much in the second half, but still pretty effective. He got the first down there.
What makes that play go is that Marquez got out around the end on that handoff earlier. Mm-hmm. So, hey, he's going again. Uh-oh, back in the I formation. And we got a timeout. 31-20 with 59 seconds to go, third quarter. Coming out of the timeout, Fontainebleau, Blocker under center, strong I formation, fumble. Loose ball.
The Bruins have it, it looks like.
The Bruins have it. So Coach Rogers calls timeout. They all go to the sideline, and he said, let's get him to fumble the ball to get it back. Wow.
And just when it looked like things were starting to click for Fontainebleau on offense, it just another turnover, another mistake that's going to help keep the Bruins in this game.
Yeah, Fontainebleau not able to put him away. Hey, let's face it, they've had plenty enough chances to do that.
I mean, at one point this was a 24-6 game, then all of a sudden within 2 minutes it was back to a four-point game.
And almost a three-point game when a touchdown by Bonnabel was called back. Mm-hmm. So crazy stuff has happened. It's the first game of the year. It's the 13th season on Channel 13. There's some kind of mystery hanging around. Second down after that run. Samaj Franklin looking, delivers. Good defensive play by Gavin Scholl. Scholl definitely smaller, which you pointed out earlier, than the receiver, comes up and knocks that one down. Good job by him.
Yeah, he timed that play really well. He got there at the exact same time at the ball to avoid the pass interference call, but to knock the ball away as well.
Third down now. You'll see the players are looking at the wristband. The plays are numbered, so if they call play number 5, he has to read it, what it is, and lets everybody know. Franklin avoids a would-be tackler, trying to make a move. Good move there. They're going to run out of bounds. Pushed out over there by Travis Sears.
Run out of bounds by Travis Sears.
I want to say, Hunter, I know this is, I know you've been in the prep zone before, and it, but I don't know if you've had Fontainebleau. Travis Sears, he's been on this team for 8 years.
Really?
Let me know. It just seems like it. It just seems like he's just playing here. Good player. Mahia back out.
Luis Mahia to punt.
Punt attempt to come. Snap a little low. Couple of steps. Mahia gets it away. Caught by Sisson. And I guess he raised his hand. Must have been a fair catch. Now, this is really good field position. I think that's 1.7 seconds.
Yeah,
is that
1.7
right?
Seconds.
It looks like it's 17, but it's 1.7 seconds to go in a quarter, third quarter. And the Bulldogs will come back out.
I've been really impressed with their defense so far here in the second half, playing very, very well. I mean, if it wasn't for a couple of mistakes on the offensive side of the ball, this game is over.
Actually, both defenses.
Yeah.
All right, in the second half. All right, blocker looking to the sideline. Empty backfield, they're gonna have motion. Snap, handoff, nope, fake. Blocker keeps, the horn goes off. End of the third quarter, we'll go to the fourth quarter with the Bulldogs up 31-20.
St. Tammany Parish Public Schools, an A-rated school district. Graduates with the highest ACT scores in the state. Facilities with the latest technology. Safe and secure schools. A variety of sports, fine arts, and learning to last a lifetime.
I'm Superintendent Trey Foles, and this is where we educate every child, every day.
Marquez breaks three. Touchdown.
34-yard touchdown run by Kendrick Marquez.
Blocker hands off to Marquez. He breaks out around the end, makes a tackle up the sideline. Touchdown. Extra point attempt to come after that great run by Marquez. Again, went back to the run. This time Marquez gets him in the end zone to start the fourth quarter and extend the lead. Olivier for the PAT.
It's good.
Kick is good. 38-20 now, Bulldogs. Olivier to kick it off. This one's short, about the 10. And when I meant that, it didn't get back to Bryant. And that runner is stopped. Up around the 30-yard line. So Mr. Samaj Franklin will be back out there with his troops.
I mean, and even though this is now an 18-point game, it's far from over. As we've seen in this game, anything can happen.
Anything can happen. But Franklin's going to have to find lightning in a bottle for sure. Rolling right, Samaj Franklin looking, dumps it off, incomplete. Waited too long to make that pass. Looking deep. Again, that was that kind of read screen where one guy may go long or make a curl. And if he's not open, you immediately dump it to the guy on the sideline. He didn't do that. He strung out the play too long. Then incomplete pass.
Yeah, it looked like he thought about taking off for a minute before he tried to dump it to May. And it just wasn't there at that point.
Back to the action. Franklin looking, gonna go deep. Everybody back, and still his receiver almost got a hand on it. He just reared back and chucked that thing.
Yeah, he also got hit pretty hard on that play. He might have rushed to get it out of there quickly, but threw it up into triple coverage, but somehow his receiver was the one that still almost came down with it.
One of the things that is unusual here in the press box is that we now have fog all over the window. Humidity outside, the air conditioning inside, and so we don't have the beautiful view that we normally have of what's going on out there. Third down, 10. Franklin going to tuck it and run. Going to go down out of bounds, but short of the first down. They'll have to punt it away. Luis Mejia will come out. He has had some work this evening.
Yeah.
He has kicking off, punting, and then receiving. So he's had plenty of play. In a coaching parlance, he would have already earned his letter for the year because he's played enough plays.
Yeah, I mean, especially in the second half, he's had a couple of catches, a couple of punts, and it looks like they're out there on fourth down going for it down by 18.
Yeah, I spoke a little too soon about our friend Mejia.
Still looks like he's out there on the field, though.
Somebody called timeout as they wanted to let everybody know that they're not punting it. They're going for it. Fourth down, Franklin directing the traffic. Snap. Gonna run it. Quarterback draw.
He's gonna get it
and a little bit more. Samaj Franklin making a big play, crossing midfield and getting the ball down to about the 48-yard line.
Yeah, he did a good job back there, coming up with the draw and just went right up the middle. The middle of the field was wide open. The Fontainebleau defense, bit on the draw, and that's a big play there by Bonnabel.
They had everybody covered, but Franklin, rolling left, completes the pass, and then knocked out of bounds over there.
Franklin's pass to Mejia. And that's a big play by Franklin, because if he doesn't make that play, then that's a turnover. Fontainebleau gets the ball back in great field position, has a chance to put the game away.
Absolutely. Still, if you'd see the Bruin, the old Bruin helmet thing, was a bee with this big bear claw hand over the top. They keep crawling back. Look at this, busted play, and Franklin gets yardage out of it. A bad snap. See, difference between him and Tyner. Tyner's still having a hard time getting the ball up. Mm-hmm. So Coach Rogers has gone with Franklin in the second half.
And that was a good job just to make something happen. Instead of falling on it, he knows he has the speed, so he picks it up and takes off to the sideline, gets out of bounds to stop the clock. So a great play there.
It's third in about six versus third and 10, or 12. Quick pass out there, complete. Gonna be short of the first down, I think.
He got that one out to Richardson pretty quickly, but it looked like
fourth and two. They converted a fourth and 10 just a minute ago.
Yeah, so this shouldn't be a problem, right?
Right. Ooh, bad
up.
Snap.
Fumble.
Big hit from Travis Sears. And Christian Maroney comes up with the football. And there you go. Fontainebleau defense steps up when it has to.
Especially here in the second half. They've played phenomenal defense here. And I think the one difference here in the second half from the first half is that they're not allowing the big pass plays down the field anymore that they did earlier on.
Right. Blocker out of the pistol. Fakes the handoff. Fakes the pitch.
Oh.
Wow. What a good play. Oh, it's pulled out of there. But I think he got back on it. Wow. Every play seems to be like this in this ball game. somebody makes a good play, and then all of a sudden somebody else makes it, and then somebody else has to make it. All in one play. Basically, he fakes out a guy, cuts it up, the guy pulls it out of his hand, and then he's able to fall on it. So,
yeah, definitely a lot of excitement with every play in this one.
High formation, play action pass. Got a man open, dumps it to the fullback in the flat. He gets a first down, and then more. Still going. I think that's Sears. I told you, he's been here forever. He's playing offense, he's playing defense, and now he's playing offense.
Yeah, he made a nice play on defense the last time out. And then comes out here, makes a nice catch, right, bowls a couple guys over, and gets a first down.
That's all you can ask. That's what I love about Friday night football. You can do anything and be anything. First down, 10, motion, Sears, fake. Blocker, again, gets a couple yards. Little extracurricular up there in the top left-hand part of your screen. Duplantis and Terrell Henry, excuse me, doing some kind of little dance up there.
Fountain Blue's done a good job of keeping the clock moving on this drive, too. A couple of good runs, a completed pass.
Play action fake. Fake again. Going deep up the sideline, incomplete. I think that was a stop and go on that sideline, and Duplantis couldn't get up there.
Yeah, it looked like Blocker almost didn't want to throw it in that direction, but he knew he had to do something with it. You know, that clock was going off in his head.
I think if he'd have gathered his feet and throw a back shoulder throw to Duplantis on the sideline. Easy to say from here. Deep, man open. In and out of his hands, incomplete. That was Greer.
Yeah, he heard footsteps from Henry that time. Just couldn't pull it in. He looks like he's down with some cramps on the sideline himself.
We have another timeout. Fourth quarter action here. 38-20, Fontainebleau over Bonnabel, 7:25 to go in this one. Coming out of the timeout, Olivier lining up. This is going to be a 43-yard field goal.
He's tried a couple from this far tonight.
Line drive, just didn't get it up.
Ball short.
So Bonnabel take over on downs. Save one touchdown. This has been a defensive struggle here in the second half.
Yeah, it has, which has been completely opposite. I mean, 51 points in the first half of this contest. Who would have thought?
Right.
In the second half, 7 points with only 7 minutes to go. Not to do or die on this drive for Franklin and the Bruins.
Franklin, handoff, left side.
Britton carries the
looks ball. Like Britton again. Got a couple yards. Clock working in Fontainebleau's favor at this moment.
Yeah, Bonnabel really aired it out in the first half when you expected them to run it, and now that they need to be, they need to go to the air. They're trying to pound it on the ground.
I know what. Time is ticking away. Or as cameraman John Harrison would know, time keeps on ticking, ticking. Oh, never I think they whistled blown him down. Look like, I don't know if it looked like he actually got down, but I'm just going to say forward progress was stopped.
Yeah, and it's a good thing that whistle for Fontainebleau, it's a good thing that whistle came in at the last second because he was about to break a long run to the outside. Big third down coming up for the Bruins. And I think they're going to talk about it first.
Timeout on the field. Seems like I said that a lot. 5:57 to go in this one. 38-20, Fontainebleau. After the timeout, Franklin dropping. Collapsing in is the defense.
Franklin.
Wow.
Was sacked by Ethan Eisenhardt.
Couldn't get it off that time. Looked like he was going to try to throw it long. Everybody covered.
Yeah, and the defensive line did a good job of getting to him before he took off. He thought about running, but there was just nowhere to go there either. A great play there, and now a big fourth down for Bonnabel.
Luis Mejia drops back for the punt.
Mejia to punt.
Single safety for the Bulldogs, number 18.
Have I said that every time?
just a few dozen times.
Mejia gets away a pretty good one. Caught, fair caught.
Kent makes the fair catch about the 47-yard line. Bulldogs take over first and 10.
Bo Turner on the, is it Turner? No, I can't. 18. Brennan Kent.
So now with the good drive, the Bulldogs have a chance to run down this clock and end this game. Taking some time to get things figured out.
Snap, handoff inside. Marquez breaks a couple of tackles, still on his feet. First down and then some. It looks like that the Bruins are kind of worn down now.
Yeah, the Bulldogs have done a good job here, especially in this second half, just pounding the ball on the ground. It looks like there's a Bruins player down, speaking of worn down.
Back out on the field, the Bulldogs fake the handoff.
Hunt Thompson
is dumped. Blocker has gone to the sideline as Coach Matern has made some changes offensively.
I'm actually a little surprised to see Thompson back in there with them trying to run the clock down. You know, Blocker is more of the runner, and he's done a great job on the ground tonight. So,
trying to give him equal time, I guess, here. Hand off inside, breaking it. Darian Curtis. Seeing his first action. Offensively tonight for the Bulldogs.
Kadarius Bryant, there's a marker on the play.
There's a flag on the field.
Thank you. looks like it's going to be on the defense.
Personal foul against the Bruins. Yard penalty on the end of one. Check that half the distance.
So that one marked off. Ball now at the 15-yard line. Oh, no, 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 no. Moving it some more. Golly.
Had some trouble counting off that time.
Well, we'll certainly remember the first game of the 13th season on Channel 13. Maybe one of the longest.
The 13-hour game.
The 13-hour game. 13.
Officials mark the ball at the 12-yard line. It's Bulldogs first and 10.
Thompson fakes the handoff, keeps it himself.
Thompson keeps. On the stop with the Bruins, 47. Price, 13, Porter. Ball is at the 6-yard line.
Letting the clock tick down.
Handoff inside. Darian Curtis.
Might be short of the first there.
Making the stop for the Bruins, number 13, Porter.
It's going to be third and short, but the ball's at about the third yard line. How about that? Well, I got to say, probably Coach Matern's got to feel pretty happy overall, get the victory, but there's some cleaning up that needs to be done.
Yeah, there is, and I think another reason for him to be encouraged is they pound in one more, I think.
I thought it was in.
Yep, so they're gonna get out of this one with a victory, and you know, they have three more home games before they hit the road for the first time, so that gives them some time to touch things up a little bit in the next few weeks, too. Although the defense has looked fantastic in the second half.
Yeah, absolutely.
Olivier to try the extra point.
Olivier's back out there. Between him and Mahia, they've had a whole season of work. Almost a one step. And he nailed it.
Oh, wow.
He nailed it. A bobbled snap. He hesitates a second, gets it, boom, kicks it through. 45-20. Fontainebleau up big. 2:08 to go in this one. Olivier to kick off. This one's going to go in the end zone, going to be a touchback.
Bruins take over at their own.
He has done a really good job on kickoffs tonight. I know he's had an interesting night kicking field goals, but on kickoffs he's done really well. Several touchbacks tonight. And I think on offense, Coach Matern also has to be impressed with the running game. I know they were hoping to come out and sling the ball around. They tried in the first half, but it's really been the running game. It's been Bastion and Marquez on the ground that's given them this huge lead in the second half.
Play being signaled in.
Thank you.
Handoff inside. And that one's whistled dead.
Ooh.
Seamus Bonnabel on the carry. Pickup of one. He stopped by a bunch of Bulldogs.
I said Franklin, he's out. Obviously, JV players in, handoff, fumble, loose ball, gonna be picked up.
Seamus Bonnabel recovers the fumble.
I think Coach Rogers has to be really disappointed in this loss. I know, you know, coming off two straight playoff appearances, they won just one game last year, was really hoping to get off to a strong start, but they fell behind early in this game and then had to claw their way back by passing the ball and getting away from his game plan.
Yeah, well, I think he saw sparks, though, in first half of them not giving up, and some good defense in the second half,
yeah,
giving up just one TD, but even, or now two, I'm sorry, but not enough of what he needed to see,
yeah,
to get a victory. So a lot of things to clean up.
Yeah, and I think he also has to be impressed with his play of his quarterback, Samaj Franklin, as well, who played well, especially in the first half, struggled a little bit here in the second half, but I think that can be credited to the Fontainebleau defense.
34 seconds to go in this one.
Luis Mejia to punt. Back deep, single safety for the Bulldogs, Brennan Kemp.
Punts away. Gonna be touched down there.
Ball is down by number 8. Raquan Hart. Bulldogs take over. They're all at the Bruin 43-yard line. Bulldog fans, the Fontainebleau players, the coaches, thank you for coming out tonight and supporting the Bulldogs.
24.5 seconds.
Opening night victory.
This is one of the best times of the game for the coach that's ahead, 45-20. They're going to take the old victory formation, take a knee, and that's going to be it. And you can see the players are lining up right there on the bottom of your screen. Getting close to being by the 50-yard line. They'll go across, although I don't know what's holding up. Come on, people. All right, okay. We're going to have the old take a knee. Are they going to do it out of the pistol? Well, I can't say that I've ever seen that until just now. And that's going to run it out, 45-20. The opening game, 13th season on 13. Fontainebleau Bulldogs at home beat the Bonnabel Bruins. We're going to send our thank yous out to those people that brought you this game, starting with our superintendent, Mr. Trey Folks, our director of broadcasting, Dr. Melody Swang, sideline camera to tonight, Brett is sharp, press box camera, Papa John Harrison. Alongside me tonight, Hunter, Mr. Robinson. I'm Charles Tiger Edwards. Good night. God bless. You be good. You are now leaving the Prep Zone.